This episode is powered by Safety FM.
The following program is rated MALSV. It contains strong language, sexual situations, and violence. It is intended only for mature audiences.
Finally, show with the balls and call it like it is. Rated R Safety Show on Safety FM.
Countdown to audio torture.
The Rated R Safety Show starts in 3, 2, 1.
Let the eardrum pain begin.
Forget the corporate bullshit. This is the Rated R Safety Show with your host, Dr. It doesn't matter who the host is.
Welcome. This is your host, Sheldon Primus, and get ready for
more sarcasm than a Mortal Kombat beatdown. Rated R Safety Show.
I guess I kind of stepped over that one. My bad. See, I'm not as good as he who shall not be named. I'm just an amateur, you know. I'm the dude that is like the pickup guy, you know. I'm the water boy that all of a sudden they say, hey, man, you want to play? Because we're like ahead by 40 and let's just throw you in there because I'm tired. Dude, pick up a bat. Get out there. And then you go out there and you strike out and they laugh at you. That's me. Right now it is, right? I don't want to be laughed at. So I'm going to get you guys started with the news for October. Tuesday, I should say, right? It is now Tuesday, and today is, and you can tell by me flipping around trying to figure out what the damn day is. I should know that, right? Tuesday, October 8th. So Tuesday, October 8th, let's get some news.
Here is the news on the Rated R Safety Show.
All right, I looked up this one. This one's kind of cool. There's 10... cool, crazy, and weird world records Malaysia holds. So if you haven't been to Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur is like awesome, I hear. My son actually did that recently, and he loved it. My nephews are about to go over there to Kuala Lumpur. All four of them are meeting up, and they're doing a brother thing, just hanging out. So that's like pretty cool. I mean, what are you going to do in Kuala Lumpur? You might, just have a little bit of fun, get out on town, and you might just tear stuff up. Just don't get arrested, right?
Duh.
So what Malaysia is best at in the world could be some of this stuff. So number one, they have the world's oldest prime minister in 2018 at 92 years and 141 days. Fuck. Wow. Dude, he's still at it. I wonder if he's like senile, and do they like have to raise his hand when it's time for like him to get people's attention, or they gotta like put hand over hand to sign documents or something crazy like that, right? Number two, they have the world's biggest banknote, and there's a picture of this lady holding banknotes, and she's got, it looks like it's gotta be one of those really big frames. And, you know, big frames, I mean, bigger than 8 by 11. It looks like one of those that's like a 15-footer. It is crazy, and that is their bill. It has a note of 600, whatever 600 is. It looks like it is, they don't even say what it is or how big it is, but it's an equivalent, it's a RM600, so that must be their dollar sign. And it is equivalent to $143. And it is actually huge. It is big. And there's this lady just holding it nice and big and a bright smile. So let's look at one more out of this. There's 10 of these, but I ain't going to go through all 10. But there's one more that's kind of cool. They actually have they're the world's fastest man to pierce 4 coconuts with his fingers. How can you freaking do that? Pierce coconuts with your finger. That is insane. And this dude, he is, let's see, Ho, that's the guy's name. It's Johor Martial Art Master Ho N Hu, right? I don't know how you spell that. I'll say that. It's H-U-I. Created a world record when he managed to pierce the husk of 4 coconuts with his index finger in 12.15 seconds until the water inside them flowed out. fucking amazing. Dude, you're my hero. That's it. Get me a coconut. I'm going to go do this now, pronto, and I will be able to beat him by 2 seconds. I'm going to do it in 10 seconds and 15 minutes. No, I'll do it in, like, never.
Duh.
That was pretty amazing. I wonder if, you know, what made him think about that? Too much Kung Fu movies, right? Well, he's, you know. Kung Fu Master, I guess you got to do something, right? You got to earn your keep somehow, right? So you don't want to make sure that your students are going to stick around with you. So you got to up the ante a little. So let's do one of the things I really, really like, which is the day of the week that we're celebrating.
More sarcasm than a Mortal Kombat beatdown. Rated R, safety show.
All right. Well, it looks like there's a few more things than yesterday. Yesterday was only two things, National Frappe Day and National Child Health Day. So today, October 8th, Tuesday. Oh, fuck. This is awesome. National Fluffernutter Day. If you do not know what a fluffernutter is, first, you probably don't have kids. Or you were abandoned as a kid. No, God. Oh, I should not have said that. Bad Sheldon. Bad
duh.
Alright, so Fluffernutter is peanut butter and marshmallow fluff. You put those two together and you close your eyes and you experience greatness as you're biting into this thing and you say, yes, my life is now complete. I've had a Fluffernutter, and that is October 8th, National Fluffernutter Day. October 8th also gets you National Pierogi Day. Oh, damn, I love me some pierogies. Pierogies are those things that you, if you live in a Polish neighborhood, you probably know about pierogies. Pierogies, they are, I'm trying to think of, they're like a giant noodle-ish type of texture that kind of looks like a ravioli. I guess I probably should have started with that one. Well, but inside you can put in potatoes, you can put in other crap. Pierogies are awesome. Look it up. Go to your local store and go get you some pierogies. There's a couple of religious ones. Yom Kippur, it actually starts today, October 8th. And so all my Jewish brethren listening to this, even though my name is Sheldon, I'm not Jewish. You know, little known fact, my mom, when she came into this country, my family's from Guyana, my mom worked for this family as in a home in, you know, 1970 at that time period, and I was born in 71, and the family there that she was working with, she loved the name Sheldon, and lo and behold, she gets pregnant, has a child, and yours truly pops up with the name Sheldon. So there we go. That's a little known fact. Oh, man. I'm not even going to... there's one that's Vijayadashami. So forgive me, my Hindu and Indian brethren. This is a holiday for you, a religious holiday. So Vijayadashami. So hopefully I said it right and I did not disrespect your religion. So please... Don't hold it against me, because I am not really good at that stuff.
Duh.
All right, so that is our news, and also the national thing that's happening for today. I want you guys to go out there and enjoy your day. If you got a rant, we're going to do rants once a week, so you could go to safetyfm.com or ratedrsafetyshow.com. Hit the button that says you want to say some shit. I'm telling you, I'm going to have to put that in there. I'm going to tell he who shall not be named. That's what I want my button to say. I got shit to say. That's my button. And I'm going to push that, and then I'm going to go off. And just go, rage. So have a wonderful rest of your week. And until the next time I guest host, peace.
This episode has been powered by Safety FM.